The smoke from burning forests, like those in Australia, can travel around the world in about a week. The hazy fumes are easy to see from space, swirling over oceans and continents. But eventually, poof, all the smoke dissipates. It seems to vanish, even though it all stays right here on planet Earth. Where does it all go? There are two parts of wildfire smoke, the stuff you can see and the stuff you can't. Each are bad for different reasons. Let's start with the visible stuff, like the Australian smoke satellites have spied over the Pacific Ocean. When forests and vegetation burn, the charred remnants of these plants take to the air as tiny particles, called particulates or aerosols. Particulates can choke the air, which is exceptionally hazardous to breathe, like they have in Australia's three most populous cities. Thankfully, winds eventually blow this pollution away, and these visible particles can travel 5 or 6 miles up into the high atmosphere. And then, they start falling down. In a week or so, most of the particles drop to the ground in rain or all by themselves. But some smoke can get lofted even higher into the atmosphere, where it can stay for over a year. Then, there's the invisible stuff, which is a much, much bigger part of the smoke. Around 90% of burned vegetation turns into the invisible and potent heat-trapping gas, carbon dioxide, or CO2. And that's really bad. CO2 can live in the atmosphere for hundreds of years, though some CO2 gets absorbed by the Earth and oceans. And, as you know, the planet already has a giant f***ing CO2 problem. Atmospheric concentrations of CO2 are the highest they've been in at least 800,000 years, but more likely, millions of years. In the past year, hundreds of big and sometimes unprecedented fires have burned in the Arctic, Alaska, the Amazon, and Australia. And the long-term consequences of these bigger blazes, CO2, will only trap more heat on our already warming planet.